Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and for the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, April 1st. PM Modi attends G7 summit in India. India repatriates mortal remains of its nationals killed in Kuwait. President Emmanuel Macron and UK's PM Rishi Sunak and Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky on the sidelines of the conference. India is participating in the summit as an outreach country. The second day of the meeting focused on migration, a crucial issue for the Italian President Giorgia Meloni as she is pushing Europe to help her curb illegal flows from Africa and also on issues related to AI and climate change. The summit also witnessed discussions over China as the countries formulate a plan to reduce Chinese influence in the world. Pope Francis was also joined by 10 other heads of state and government, including PM Modi and the King of Jordan, who also led a discussion on the ethical implications of artificial intelligence. This is India's 11th participation in the G7 summit and PM Modi's 5th consecutive participation. Modi's presence is seen as a bridge between the G7 and the broader international community, particularly the Global South. A special Indian Air Force plane arrived in India's Kochi and New Delhi on Friday, carrying the mortal remains of Indian nationals killed in the Kuwait building fire tragedy. Around 40 Indians and 9 others died in the blaze in Mangav city, while more than 50 were injured. Authorities have said out of the 40 victims, 23 were from Kerala, 7 from Tamil Nadu, 3 from Andhra Pradesh and 1 each from states of Bihar, Odisha, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, Haryana, Punjab and West Bengal. While the Kuwait Fire Service has said an electrical short circuit caused the blaze, the state agency Kuna reported that Kuwaiti prosecutors have asked authorities to bring one citizen and a number of residents into protective custody over accusations of manslaughter due to safety negligence. Millions of foreign workers make up the majority of the labor force in Kuwait and some of its Gulf neighbors and often live in overcrowded accommodations. Moving on, the soaring prices of sacrificial livestock in Pakistan ahead of Eid al-Adha have taken a toll on customers as they are struggling to get a bargain amid economic downturn. Take a look.
Pakistanis thronging markets to buy sacrificial cows, camels and goats for the upcoming Eid al-Adha festival are complaining about rising prices of the livestock this year. Pakistan has been beset by inflation above 20% since May 2022. Last year in May, inflation jumped as high as 38% as the country navigated reforms as part of an IMF bailout program. While inflation has since tapered, at the main cattle market in Karachi, Pakistan's biggest city, customers said they were still facing higher prices than last year.
मेरे ख्याल से तो ऐसा कोई फर्क नहीं है महंगाई तो पिछले हिसाब से बहुत ज़्यादा ही है सही है और पिछले साल जो थी एक तक के जो जानवर था वो आज डेढ़ तक के पहुंचा हुआ है महंगाई और बढ़ ली है मज़ीद गरीब आदमी जो है ना मेरे ख्याल से एक तक का जानवर लेने के लिए ना मुश्किल है बहुत मुश्किल है एक तक का जानवर जो है ना मिलना मुश्किल है
Trader Mohammed Chuttil, who travelled some 540 kilometres from the city of Ghotki to sell his cows and bulls in Karachi, said the impact of last year's high inflation continued to be felt this year. The few customers that are coming are only choosing smaller animals, the trader said.
पहले जो जानवर पाला है ना पिछले साल से बहुत चारा महंगा था, तुड़ी महंगी थी, जो भी चारा था बहुत महंगा था। अभी आगे जो अगले साल आएगा उसमें कोई कमी होएगी इसमें ये तो पहले महंगा है पहले चारा चारा इसको खिलाया है अभी दो तीन महीने हुए इसमें कमी आई है चारे में भी कुछ
Pakistan narrowly averted a default last summer thanks to a short-term IMF bailout of $3 billion over 9 months. The government unveiled a budget earlier this week in line with IMF demands as it seeks another loan estimated to be between $6 to $8 billion that is likely to aggravate inflationary woes.
Moving on. The Taliban must provide Ryan Corbett, an American aid worker held in Afghanistan, with medical treatment without delay, Alice Jill Edwards, a UN expert, said on Thursday. She said she had raised the issue directly with the Taliban, as without proper medical care, he is at risk of irreparable harm or even death. Corbett and his family had moved to Afghanistan in 2010. They left following the Taliban takeover in 2021, but he went back in January 2022 to renew his business visa and provide consulting to private sector through his NGO. Despite having a valid visa, he was arrested by the Taliban in August 2022 when he returned to pay and train his staff. The UN expert said Corbett has developed several medical problems, including ringing in his ears and severe weight loss. He has also repeatedly expressed intentions of suicide and self-harm. The United States has had no diplomatic presence in Kabul since it fell to the Taliban in August 2021. Sri Lankan President Ranil Wickremesinghe on Thursday recalled the assistance received from India and Bangladesh during the early days of the worst economic crisis and said the island nation would not have been able to recover from the turmoil had these countries not helped. Speaking during the 45th SAARC Finance Governors Meeting and Symposium, Wickremesinghe underscored the significance of the financial aid, which amounted to $3.5 billion from India and $200 million from Bangladesh, and called both life saviors. He said many did not expect Sri Lanka to come out of the crisis so quickly. The country ran short of fuel for essential services such as buses, trains and medical vehicles because it did not have enough reserves of foreign currency to import anymore. And at least 6 people have been killed and around 2,000 tourists remain stranded in India's Sikkim after incessant rainfall triggered landslides and floods in the northeastern state. According to authorities, landslides were reported from several locations in Mangan in North Sikkim, snapping connection to the district. Similar damages were reported from neighbouring Kalimpong district of West Bengal, where heavy rains uprooted trees and left roads and property damaged. Similarly, in Nepal's Taplejung district, landslides have claimed at least 4 lives. While eastern parts of Nepal have been lashed by heavy rains, the Himalayan country's western areas are facing one of the hottest seasons, weather officials have said.
वो हम लोगों का गैरेज है, गैरेज वगैरह सब डूब गया है, गाड़ी वगैरह सब चला गया है, जितना था, अभी तो यहाँ पे रेंट पे रह रहा था, यहाँ पे हम लोगों का बाइक का गैरेज था, सब लोगों का सब कुछ था यहाँ पे, अभी भी सब चला गया है।
And hundreds of devotees gathered at the famous Mata Kheer Bhavani temple in India's Jammu and Kashmir and offered kheer or sweet milk pudding to a sacred spring as part of the Hindu festival of Kheer Bhavani on Friday. The annual event, which displays communal harmony, witnessed people from different religions performing rituals and chanting prayers at the temple. There are many legends associated with the temple and the goddess. It is believed that Lord Hanuman had brought the deity in the form of water in a pot made of pumpkin or coconut shell at this place. The festival is celebrated every year in the May and June period and is seen as the biggest symbol of communal harmony as Kashmiri Pandits and Muslims gather together to mark the occasion.
Prarthana to main yahi karunga ki aman aur shanti aa jaye, wahi bahar aa jaye 90 se pehle ki bahar jahan pe Kashmiri Pandit Musliman ke saath बैठता था, एक ही थाली में खाते थे और लगता नहीं था मुसलमान कौन है, हिंदू कौन है। और मैं कामना करता हूँ माता रानी से कि वैसे ही दिन फिर से आ जाएं, वो भाईचारा फिर से हमें कायम हो जाए।
पहले हम लोग यहाँ पे आए, जल चलाया हम लोगों ने, जो कच्ची लस्सी थी, फिर हम लोगों ने पूजा वगैरह की, फिर हम लोगों ने दिया जलाए, फिर यहाँ पे आके हम लोगों ने चुनरी वगैरह जो थी वो चढ़ाई और फिर साथ में हम लोगों ने प्रसाद वगैरह लिया यहाँ से सारा।
कैसा लगा यहाँ पे आके?
काफी अच्छा लगा, फर्स्ट टाइम था, अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था, काफी अच्छा लगा यहाँ पे आके।
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.